so much fun. You know, did all the craziest things, but you still won games.
Yeah.
And you still dominated teams. And one of the things that we want to look at now is how you dominated the state of California, beating the 49ers twice.
Cool. California
State champions.
Let's take a look at that.
California now. State champions.
Don't be scared.
Nervous.
1991 Atlanta Falcons, California state champs. We had beaten every single team on the West Coast.
What's this hurt?
Yes! 2011?
We beat San Francisco in San Francisco, and the Falcons had never beat the Rams in L.A.
Oh, beating them twice, beating the 49ers, I sure hope so, man. That'd be great. That'd be great. I don't know how long it's been since they've done that around here.
There goes Tolliver, a long, high pass, down in the corner, batted. They fight. Touchdown! Touchdown! Touchdown!
Oh, my gosh!
I'd rather have luck than skill, baby.
I said somebody catch it! I closed my eyes and said...
That was the catch.
That was the first catch.
I love you, man. You made it successful.
What was the locker room like after that?
Oh man, you know, we had beaten the 49ers, who had been dominating us for years. And that was we beat them twice in the same season. Right. And, I mean, that pretty much springed us into the playoffs because we won that game. We had the edge over them. So we both finished 10-6 that year. But we beat them twice, so we had to edge, so that brought us into the playoffs.
Kicked them out of the playoffs.
Yes, got them out and got us in. And the locker room went crazy, man. I mean, if you saw what happened on the field, when we got back into the locker room, it was just like that.
And they were like the standard of that era, right? Like the 80s and 90s.
Absolutely.
They were the team to beat.
They won three Super Bowls in the 80s. Yeah.
That's true.
And in the pregame, the pregame for one of those, or for both games, your locker room was going crazy, and their locker room was very stoic and silent, right?
Right.
What was that like?
It took on the persona of Bill Walsh, you know?
Right.
He was a genius. He was tactical. This man here was wide open and fun, and we were rolling beforehand. That's kind of how we played.
We went to the league meetings, and all the head coaches there, you guys will love this because you know who I am. And Bill Walsh says, Jerry, I would like to have dinner with you and our wives. I think we should go out to dinner together. And I said, why is that, Bill? He said, you're at the zenith of all of football. I said, Bill, I don't talk like that. Should I hit you in the mouth or what? I didn't know if it was a compliment or what. I was at the zenith. What the hell is that?
Chris, one thing I want to say, too, that I want to get overlooked. You see the trophy, right?
Yeah.
Who does that, man? What other team would make a trophy and put California State champions?
That's what I was going to say.
That was so cool.
That
was the first time it ever happened, right, Jerry?
Never happened since before.
Nobody had ever went and swept the whole left coast.
That's what kind of swag we had. That's kind of fun we had.
The 49ers.
San Diego.
The Raiders.
The Raiders.
Seattle.
Yeah, we played Seattle.
We got them all.
The Raiders. Everybody on that
Raiders.
And who else would think about doing it?
Right, that's right.
My man over there.
I thought it was so cool.
And what stands out to you about those games from the Niners or the Rams or any of those teams in California?
The biggest thing that stands out the most to me were, why were we in the NFC West? Yeah. With the NFC South, right? Okay, mm-hmm. We're in the South, but you still had the Falcons and the Saints, and you had the LA Rams and San Francisco. California. It didn't make any sense how they had those listed in the West for all those years, but... But it was a long flight every year.
There were some great road trips.
But that was some great road trips.
They were on the road. That's where it was. They were on the road.
And those teams were strong, too. Back in the 90s.
Rams were stout.
They was pretty strong, man. So it was a time for me to get focused.
Well, the 49ers had the best team money could buy.
Oh, yeah.
There was no salary cap. Uh-huh. And DeBartolo had all the money he wanted.
Yeah. Yeah.
So we couldn't outbid and get anybody. They could come get your players because with no salary cap, you go where the money is.
You guys remember some of those plane flights coming home, too, after a big win?
Oh, yeah.
We're landing, no seatbelts on. We're standing like this, trying to surf the landing.
And chicken. That were the best times ever.
You imagine we flying back from the West Coast. Uh-huh. We get back 7 o'clock in the morning the next day because of the time change. Yeah. So. And you're talking about fun on some flights. Yeah. Can't tell you what happened on some flights.
Didn't sleep much. Let's put it that way. We didn't sleep
much. One of our linemen, Mike Ken, played 17 years, and several of us, when we got back from those West Coast trips, we just go to his bar and kick it up the next day and keep going.
Rafters.
Yeah. Play cards, play dice.
What about practice?
Mondays were off. Mondays were film days. Mondays were film days. You could go and watch some film. You'd be a little cloudy. Tuesdays was an off day. We'd be good by Wednesday.
So when y'all beat the 49ers that season twice, did y'all know, was that kind of a point where you realized that y'all might be on to something special, or was it a different point in the season?
I would say it was before that. Mm-hmm. We started rolling as a team before that. We started the season off 0-2 that year.
Yeah, right. People don't remember that.
They don't, yeah.
They forget.
And then we won a game, then we lost another game, so we were at 3-3. And we finished the season at 10-6. So, I mean, we started rolling, and we started winning games.
Started
so before that,
win.
Yeah. Exactly. We started expecting to win. Yeah. And before you know it, man, we were just rolling wins off, rolling. Like Robert said earlier, we were winning the games we wasn't supposed to win, and also winning the games we should have won.
Yeah. Yeah.
We had a new offense coordinator that you brought in June Jones in 91.
Big difference, yeah.
Year before, we had Tom Rossi, who went to Green Bay with Favre.
And catching that Hail Mary that I see, what is that like, catching a Hail Mary? That
When did you know you had it?
Here's the thing you don't hear. I got shut out the whole game. That was my only catch.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Yeah.
That was my only catch.
Mike,
so I got shut out, huh?
You got the best one.
Absolutely.
Yeah. You got the only one in the bedroom.
We had been going back and forth with the score. And we end up kicking a field goal, and then they scored a touchdown.
We were up 10-7, and Charles Haley buried me in the ground. I got cracked ribs, still got a lump up in there. We were up 10-7, so Billy Joe went in, hit a big-time comeback on the sideline.
Yeah, he had a big...
Launched the Hail Mary.
Who caught the big out?
Yeah, that was the big out. Yeah,
Andre caught it. I mean, I'm talking about touching the ball out there on a big third down,
third
down.
Led to the Hail Mary.
And that just got us close enough to throw the Hail Mary.
Yeah. Mike, but tell everyone, it wasn't luck, though. Tell them what you guys do at practice every
day. What'd you do after?
With barrels.
We used to do this thing they called it buckets. And the quarterbacks used to put, I don't know how far you
got. About 44 yards.
44 yards. And their whole thing was to throw the ball into the buckets. It was a trash can.
And they had to throw it
into 6 yards from the sideline. 44 yards, 6 yards from the sideline.
So we practiced that.
And you were the bucket.
He was the bucket
at that time. Yes,
he became the bucket.
It was one of those things. You got all these guys down there, and it's a free fall. You're just trying to go get the ball. Yeah.
And for y'all, Jesse and Rob, what was it like game planning for that offense
tough.
For the 49ers? For 49ers,
I'll tell you that right now, extremely tough. Because you're playing against the West Coast offense that run multiple formations out of a two back set, and they had skilled athletes, and they had a great quarterback.
And they always
You got Steve Young, you got Jerry Rice, you got John Taylor, you got Roger Craig. You're talking about
Well, Joe Montana was the...
When Montana left, Steve Young was
missed. Well, you two are like this when they had them both.
I had them both.
Yeah. And I would coach him.
Yeah.
And I told the defense, if any of you knock Joe Montana out of the game, I'm cutting you.
Right.
We don't want that Steve Young coming in. We wanted Joe Montana.
So you knew.
Yeah, we all knew.
We all knew he'd be a superstar.
But the biggest thing we do was that when Steve was in the game, 80% of their offense was going where?
80.
To their left.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Left-handed. Because he's left-handed?
Boomer. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So that was one thing, but he was so athletic, you know,
yeah, you
he could
stop
do it
him.
All.
Yeah.
But you knew that most of the stuff was going to our right, his left, you know what I mean? But overall, the offense for me was they would put somebody in every part of the field.
Yeah.
So he had a threat every, so you had to be right. And I got caught a time or two cheating.
you mentioned you had to cover Jerry Rice on occasion.
Yeah. In cover four, we ran a lot of cover four. When we wasn't blitzing. We blitzed a lot. You know, ran man-to-man a lot. But when you cover four, anytime, you know, I knew I had three on the strong side, whoever come in, but they knew it too, so they're bringing Jerry in and run an option right off of me.
Right.
So you already, everybody knows where the ball's going. I know where the ball's going. Yeah. My goal is, can I stop Jerry Rice? No. Can I tackle him? Yes, for 8 yard gain. So my biggest thing is just make the tackle, man. Make the tackle.
Front.
Because, you know, when you're playing superstars like that, you're not particularly as a backer, you're not going to defend the ball. You're not going to knock a ball down. Yeah. My goal was to knock him down as hard as I possibly could.